Don't miss The Divas. Subscribe to Big CBS Love on your set-top box today. SMS Love to 55454 to get Big CBS Love. The Diva Destination.
Well, frankly, I'm not very sure, but I think the kind of work that has been happening from the agency and what we partner the client. So over the last 10-15 years, there's been a lot of award-winning work which has come through the teams and through the agency, and by default, because I lead the pack through us. So I guess in a way, the recognition also comes to the senior. So some part of the recognition has come to us. I think neither. I think in today's day and age, it doesn't matter whether you're a male or a female. As long as you deliver on the task, you deliver on the job, I think it gets, you get your promotions, you do well. Depending on what kind of work you put out, I'm not sure it matters any longer whether you're a male or a female. Media planning, buying has been a relatively new phenomenon. In fact, when I joined advertising, we were part of the mainline advertising agency. Media planning, buying moved out of it only about 15-18 years back. And even 15-18 years back, women had started coming into the workforce. So I think with equal opportunity given, equal amount of women have risen to the top. So it's not that, because it's a relatively new field, we frankly gained and had the opportunity to also become as good as any counterpart, male or female. See, to a large extent, the gender equality discussion has been happening globally. And everybody understands now that 50% of the workforce globally are women. They're not just, earlier you only had men as your option. Now everyone understands that it's better to get the balance 50% in, because their options open out. It's not just about, showing preference towards male. The larger workforce that you have, the better output you'll have, the better yield you'll have, that it will make a lot more sense. So everybody's opened up to the idea that if it's an area where a male or a female can do same kind of job, then why not? And certainly a lot of people have opened out and let the female force come in. In fact, interestingly, if you see at the business school levels, and at the entry level, organizations like us, and I'm sure a lot of organizations, actually have an equal amount of male and female who come in. What happens is, I think along the journey, when you get married, when you have kids, when husbands transfer, circumstances make women in a way get off the career path. A lot of organizations have started creating policies which enable women to stay. Obviously that's a natural evolution, but I'd like to step back, into where we're coming from and where we are going. Traditionally, we used to have a one-income household, and we used to have male bastions and female bastions. So in marketing terms, you would find that, like technology, cars, finance, house, used to be very male targeted at. So all our advertising, all our marketing efforts, everything used to be male. As opposed to a female, where you would think household products, FMCG goods, creams, lotions, hair oil, edible food, all these are very female, bastions, and they're to be now addressed to the female. But with the changes and women coming into the workforce, women go home and men go home at the same time, and they leave at the same time. As a result, these traditional chores that, you know, males used to do and females used to only do cooking, males used to only do bank work, I think those have all broken down. And you will find that a new adjustment has happened, and males and females are doing similar kind of work. It may be a coincidence that this sort of one chore a male has taken up in one household, but that same thing may be done by a female in another household. Now, if this behavior pattern has changed, then you will find that the buying decision behavior pattern also changes. So it's possible that a male goes to the mall or to a store and buys. And then he takes the decision, and then he picks up his shampoo and he picks up his cream and he picks up stuff, edible oil or whatever. So we have now realized that it's not that you can target only a male or a female. In a way, you know, it's an open book, and each household, the pattern is evolving, and it's not necessarily like the old one. So both have grown important. So for an FMCG, suddenly we are looking at males, because, I mean, you can see Johnny Bravo and he's using a cream, and you can see Shah Rukh Khan, and you can see all kinds of male ads which are addressing males for products which were traditionally bought by women, right? And similarly, you can see ads which you find that, you know, a finance or a life insurance or, you know, houses, phones, like a mobile phone. I mean, I don't know if it's a male or a female. I don't know, is it growing? The product has grown in importance, and both male and female have equally grown in importance. So it's not like it was male or female. So I think now the roles have changed, and as a result, you will find that there's no longer a male bastion or a female bastion. Both have, you know, grown in the non-traditional bastions that they have. Not really. I think, gossip is a prerogative of both men and women. So what you talk during lunch, men are talking and women are talking. In the train, men are talking and women are talking. So I don't think any longer. And the decision-making, the decision-making process for both, in a way now, has become social, so to speak. So if you see the social networks, everybody's checking out what the other one is buying and the opinion. So it's not that if you see a post by a male, he may say, you know, I want to buy this thing, what's your opinion? Yeah. And he's getting feedback from everybody, and so are women. So the feedback from social networks or from networks, whichever they, I think is normal, and is a good thing, is required, is wanted, because how else will you know? Because you believe that the company will put out only the better things. So you want an unbiased opinion, and you may get an unbiased opinion from very limited people. So you want from a larger group of people, and you will start looking at sites. In fact, a lot of marketing money these days is being spent on the social networks to see how to manage that conversation. And how to manage a conversation, or how to create a conversation, or how to get people to participate in it, has become a really large marketing effort now across all companies, not only in India but globally. So you're saying really, I think females come more into prominence because, frankly, there aren't too many. But if you see the global numbers yet, the global numbers at the top are barely 4% and 5%, 6%. The phenomena has just started. Yeah, it will take time to change. So now our kids, you don't see a difference between my male kid and a female kid. You will treat them similarly. But such children are just about coming into the workforce for the last 15, 20 years in liberalization. Since last 20 years, you can see the difference that is coming. Till 1970, almost, you could see it was a very male, you know, only the boys used to be preferred. And now I think it's become a lot more equal, at least in the larger towns. Certainly that is happening in the smaller towns, that, you know, if you have only one income in the family, should you educate your male or should you educate your daughter? And maybe people yet prefer male. But I think now you will find equal workforce coming in. I think, sir, a person who is frankly self-satisfied in her image of herself and her image of success, if she's, you know, she's satisfied with it, I think she's a diva in her own mind. I mean, if I would look at myself, I'm not gunning to imagery of someone else. I have to think what I want to do, what is right and wrong for me, what I would like to achieve. And if I feel that I have done it, I'm happy with that. So at any point of time, if somebody would have said, would you compromise between family and career, I would have said, no, I want both. And if that makes me greedy, yes. If that makes me a diva, yes. If whatever. So I think somebody who's satisfied with your image of your success, your happiness is a diva. Who else? Why would I want to listen to somebody else's definition of a diva and satisfy that definition?